Well, a warning from former Supreme Court Associate Justice Antonio Carpio to Davao del Norte Representative Pantaleon Alvarez, who has been tasked to lead the signature campaign for the secession of Mindanao. See, Carpio warns Alvarez could face sanctions, pointing to a provision in the Code of Conduct that government officials must not be disloyal to the Republic. Joining us now to explain this new push for an independent Mindanao is Congressman Alvarez himself. Congressman, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Hi, Carmina. Good afternoon.
All right. So first off, we were able to speak to a lot of officials, several officials, since your call for secession. I was able to speak with Attorney Sema, Deputy Parliament Speaker, the other day. Plainly, he's saying secession is not the solution, that you can speak for Mindanao and so many for Mindanaoans on so many issues, but this is not one of them. Who are you speaking for, Congressman Alvarez?
Well, Carmina, first of all, no, I really respect their position. Now, dito po sa ano sa Davao, ang sentiments po namin ay mukhang hindi naman kasi masyadong maganda yung serbisyo na nakukuha namin from the national government ngayon.
But you were elected to by the people to take care of the needs of the people. As well, Congressman, not just
yes,
to look
true.
To the national government to help your constituents. You're there. You're in a position to affect change. Go ahead.
Yes, that's true. But look at this time, Carmina. Walang tigil yung ulan. Unprecedented yung flooding dito sa Davao del Norte. Why? Because when the new administration took over, 2023 budget, majority of major infrastructure projects, that includes flood protection, na cancel ng present administration. 2024 budget, ganun din ang ginawa. Ito yung pinrogram ng DPWH after consultation with the regional development councils.
But this government, or there were governments or administrations that came before this, and we know that certain infrastructure, especially infrastructure projects and flood control programs, they don't happen overnight. Can you remind me again, Congressman, this is your, are you on your
and last term.
So you've been there for quite a while.
Yes, yes. And you know, itong mga flood control, Carmina, these are big amounts, no, na hindi ito binibigyan sa isang budget season. Minsan multi-funding ito eh. Multi-year funding. Ang problema, merong mga naumpisahan tapos pinahinto. E ngayon pagka ganitong umuulan, nagigiba ulit yung inumpisa na proyekto. So sayang, para ka nagtapon ng pera ng gobyerno.
As you're speaking, Congressman Alvarez, really the video that we've been showing our viewers, devastating, heartbreaking, the landslides that have been happening, the flooding that has been happening there in the region. Here's the thing. The so-called People's Initiative, you stood up against that. You're standing up against that, saying it is not genuine. There is no clamor. There are more important issues. You said that about the People's Initiative. How is that initiative now different from your call to secede? I talked to, as I mentioned, several officials in the past days since your call to secede. There is no clamor. That's what they're saying. There are more important issues. That's what they're saying as well. And you look at the flooding and the landslides, that's where you need to focus on. That's what they're saying, and not this call to secede. How do you defend yourself against that?
Well, yung solution, Carmina, let's say, no, yung flooding, andyan na. Ito nga, dahil nga huli kami palagi sa priority. Kung hindi huli, nakakalimutan. Kaya pagka ganyan, ano pang aasahan namin sa gobyerno? So we have to find a way kung saan ay yung namang mga concerns ng tao dito ma-address. ng gobyerno.
Hindi niyo ho ba yun kayang i-address? Can't you address that, being that you're a sitting congressman?
Ay, hindi kaya ko.
Well, how so? Why?
Kahit na anong gawin mo dyan sa House of Representatives, kahit pumasok ka araw-araw, mag-attend ka ng mga committee hearings, sessions, kapag kahalimbawa, you're not the type na marunong sumipsip doon sa nakaupo, eh talagang wala kang makukuha.
So you're blaming the current leadership of the House of Representatives for the flooding that's happening there in Mindanao as we speak?
Logically, yes.
Why not put, there's plenty of blame to go around, but there were past administrations and past leaders before we got to this. Why not blame them as well?
May mga naumpisahan kasi noon eh. Ngayon, pagpasok ng bagong administrasyon, hindi ito tinatapos. Kinansel pa.
You know, very different from what Congressman Zia Alonto Adyong said. We interviewed him yesterday as well. This is what he said. He said, in fact, Mindanao has been reaping the gains of having had a Mindanaoan president of the Republic. And that same former president is now calling for the secession of Mindanao. Tell us, Congressman Alvarez, how does that make sense to you?
Well, maybe doon sa area niya, ganun yung sitwasyon, no? And I respect his opinion. Pero dito sa amin, dito sa area ko, mukhang hindi. Kaya I have to speak for the people also.
How do you defend yourself, Congressman Alvarez, from the observation that this call for Mindanao to secede is a shallow call? There's nothing behind it.
Well, siguro, Carmina, kasi ito naman, hindi naman to natin iso-shortcut kagaya ng ginagawa sa People's Initiative. Talagang we will take the pain of going around Mindanao, explaining to the people, answering the questions, why and what.
But shouldn't it be the other way? You're saying there was a clamor. Why is there a need to explain? If the clamor is coming from the people, why do you need to take the pain to go around to explain to them what this is all about?
Siyempre, kasi meron pang ibang hindi nakakaintindi. Hindi naman lahat ng tao kagad-agad naiintindihan nila yung gagawin, no? Dahil medyo, siyempre, mahirap dahil malaking move. So we have to explain to the people para maintindihan nila at magkaisa talaga.
Congressman, various legal experts have already said that including former Associate Justice Tony Carpio, we also spoke to him yesterday, the chances of this becoming a possibility is zero. That it is an impossibility, according to some. How far are you willing to go to make this a possibility, Congressman?
Carmina, I would rather do something rather than be contented with the zero. Kaysa wala kang ginawa, mabuti na yung may gagawin ka.
So hanggang saan niyo po dadalhin ito?
Hanggang siguro sa punto na ma-realize namin yung advocacy.
So hanggang dulo, hanggang magkaroon talaga ng separate at independent Mindanao?
Hanggang dulo po.
But here's the thing. The MNLF abandoned the call for independence. The MILF abandoned the call for independence. You now have the Bangsa Mauro Autonomous Region of Muslim Mindanao. It's been solved. There's been a resolution. And yet here you are stirring things up again. Yan po ang pananaw ng iba. How do you defend yourself against that?
Okay, yung creation ng basic law ng Bangsa Mauro. It happened nung ako ay nakaupong Speaker of the House of Representatives.
Exactly.
So I'm familiar with the issues, Carmina. At masaya ako pagka halimbawa ngayon kontento na sila doon, no? At na-deliver ng government yung mga dapat na kinumit ng gobyerno na ibigay sa kanila.
And the next logical step, according to Attorney Sema, is to precisely call for charter change to entrench the BARM into the Constitution. But you're doing the opposite. Ang sinasabi po niya, pag ginawa yon, all the questions about the organic law and other issues regarding BARM, that will be resolved.
Okay, the problem is this. Maganda sana yan kung doon sa sinasabi nilang amendment ng Constitution, malinaw kung ano yung amendahan ng mga provisions. Mm. Kaya lang, sinasabi lang nila economic provisions. Eh, hindi nga malinaw ano yung economic provisions. How are you going to phrase it? Walang paliwanag, walang explanation. Wala pong sinasabi. Wala kang pwedeng basahin kung ano yun.
But do you have the same opinion that changing the charter is an opportunity to entrench the BARM in the Constitution?
Depende sa provision ng Constitution na papalitan.
So why not go that way? Instead, you're going the other way, which is to have an independent Mindanao.
You know, we tried that several times. In fact, during the incumbency of President Duterte, he tried to revise the Constitution, change the form of government from a unitary to a federal form of government. Mm-hmm. Basically, to address yung concerns ng like sa BARM, yung mga ibang ethnic groups, no? Para ma-address naman.
Yeah.
So, kaya lang.
Go ahead.
Too difficult, no? Dahil maraming resistance, ayaw ng Senado at that time. Tapos ayaw nalang galawin kasi sinasabi nila perfect daw yung constitution natin. Hindi ko makita paano naging perfect yan. Ang daming defect.
Right. Some are also observing you, Congressman Alvarez, about what your motivation is. I told you a while ago, one of the observations is that this call is shallow. Others are saying it's possibly because of 2025. What is your motivation here, Congressman Alvarez?
No, 2025 elections, Carmina, is not my concern. Last term ko ngayon sa Congress, sa House of Representatives.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. At wala naman akong balak na tumakbo ng higher position, no? Dito lang ako sa province. So wala akong problema dyan.
Finally, you're a sitting official, Congressman Alvarez, elected by the people. You swore to preserve and defend the Constitution. You're also a lawyer. You took an oath to uphold the Constitution. How is this call to secede not a betrayal now of those two oaths that you took, Congressman?
Well, simply put, Carmina, I am ready to face any sanction or anuman yung na-violate ko. Kung merong ethical, merong violation sa ethics, well, sige, okay. I will face that.
We're going to have to leave it at that. Congressman Pantaleon Alvarez there, former House Speaker, thanks a lot for taking our Zoom call this noon. Really appreciate it.
Okay, maraming salamat.
Maraming salamat po.